Hello, my good people of God. Good afternoon, wherever you are watching me from. Good afternoon. I greet you in the name of God, the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. I came to tell you that today I have a word for you. I have a word of God for you. Because we are about to enter new year. First, we need God. In everything we do, we need God. And we have to appreciate the one that He has done so that He can do a new thing for us again. Okay, whatever you are passing through, whatever you are going through in this life, you must remember that there is God. There is God who creates heaven and earth, that He has always been with you. He has always been in your backbone. He has never let you. So this is the reason why you have to thank God. Anytime you slept, you wake up, you have to give praises to Him. You have to worship Him. You have to honor Him. You have to let people know that He exists. His existence of God is sure. So before I start talking to you about God, I have to want us to close our eyes to pray. Because with prayer, all things are possible. Father, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, everlasting King of glory, ancient of days, our Father, that I worship you. I lift your children before you. Whosoever that watches this video, as you type amen, may your life be shattered with amen. May celebration never lack in your life. Whatever all you have expected in this new year, may God Almighty grant you your heart desire in the powerful name of Jesus. He that created you, He never sleeps or slumber. So therefore, He's watching over you everywhere you go. May God Almighty preserve you, protect your family. Everything you lay hand upon, may God Almighty bless it for you. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Alpha and Omega, you are worthy to be prayed once again. I greet you, my good people of God. Wherever you are watching me, in Nigeria, in Europe country, I greet you once again. My name is Blessing Richard. One and only. The good friend, the best friend you have, that always say the truth. And the truth here, I'm going to say again today. Please, thank you very much for stopping by. What I want to say about serving God. Serving God does not mean that you must have money before you serve God. No. God does not need your money to serve Him. He does not need your money before He will bless you. He did not need your money. All what He needs for us is thanks. Just that, like your father will buy you a new something that you cherish so much. Then when your father came home and he called you, son, I brought you a surprise. What you have to say to your father, oh, thank you, daddy. Thank you, I really appreciate. So our father is just like God, the way God is to us, that's how our biological father also, we are also, is also, the position that God is acquired in our life, our biological father also have rights in that very position. God has pushed times so much, times. And the second one, forgiveness. Forgiveness. When you are expecting something, when you are praying, then you are having grudges. You are having hatred in your heart. That prayer would, it was like delaying. And when your prayer is delaying, you will lose interest. You will lose hope. And this is what God tells us, that we should not lose hope. But what can hinder a prayer most is grudges and hatred, unforgiveness, spirits. It can hinder prayer. And it's not good for a Christian's brother, a Christian sister, to have those things that I just mentioned now. When you know that you are that kind of person who don't forgive, who don't have the spirit of forgiveness, please, I beg you in the name of God, try and research your heart and learn how to forgive. Okay? Because this life is all about forgiveness. We cannot do it ourselves. Okay? The blessing that God will bless you, will not add sorrow. It will not add pain to your life. It's the kind of blessing that it will bless you. When you sleep in the night, you will sleep like a baby and wake up like a giant. Not when you sleep, you will be dreaming that a human being using mortar to pursue you. Someone will be knocking your door without you are not expecting anybody. It's a very strange thing. Because we are a human being, all we expect in this life, we should be happy when we are having the wealth. A wealth that cannot give you happiness, that always give you sleepless night, it's not a wealth. It's not something that you should be glad of, you should be rejoicing. When other people are busy sleeping in their house in the night, you will be busy going to beer parlor from beer parlor to beer parlor because why? You cannot be able to sleep well. I cannot afford that because sleep in the night is very important. So please, I want to beg you, if you are that kind of person who don't forgive, who always have this heart that there's nothing they stop, nothing they happen. There's something is sopping, eh? Something is really soppy. If you say that nothing they stop, things they stop. This what we are now. So many things they stop. Where? So please, if you never stop where you did, I pray that God will not allow it to stop for where you did. Okay? Please learn how to forgive. We know that in this life, so many people offend you. Even if you don't even offend them, you will not just know how come. You will just see enmities will just fall from nowhere, just like a manna fall from heaven. Boom. So you will not know where the enmity is coming from. So you will be asking yourself question: how do I offend this person? How do I offend this woman? How do I offend this lady? How do I offend this girl? So they want to test your faith. They want to test your faith. But when they say that the more they are testing you, you are not falling into the trap, they will now know that you are serving the living God. Okay? They will now know that you are very different. You are a different person. But when they try to threaten you about you don't offend anybody, they will just try to wake up in the morning, you greet them, nobody will answer you. Then you say, okay, don't worry. Since I greeted you today, you don't answer me, I will not greet you tomorrow. So when they try you like that, then you fall into the temptation. That is the easy way from devil to get through your life. Because devil doesn't supposed to have key to your life, because the key of our life belongs to God Almighty, who created heaven and earth. So when you start to release your key of your life to the enemy, is when you are falling into their trap. That is where you will start to release the key of your life. Who's supposed to be in the hands of God? You are not telling God, please give me the key of my life. Let me give it to this enemy, because you are giving them the capacity to come into your life, which is not supposed to be like that. So when you are giving them key, when you are giving enemy key that's supposed to belong to Jesus, you are dragging it from Jesus. Because why Jesus is, why he will release that key for you is when you are not believing him, you don't have mind of forgive, you don't listen to the word of God, you don't believe things of God, then God don't have choice to release the key. He will say, enemy, go and try this vessel. If you succeed, fine. If you don't succeed, fine. I have seen so many cases like that. A lady came out from church to preach that there was a time where he was loving word of God. He was a Christian, a devoted Christian, and that. So that our first child died, because when you are serving God, you must see temptation. Our first child died, and this child, he was looking for a child for so many years. Although I don't blame the woman, because it's somehow that a child that you have been waiting for so many years, you have it, and later you lost the child. So when the child started sick, this lady was praying. He was taking this child all church to church. God, please heal my child. You are the person who gave me this child. Please don't let anything to happen to her. So at the long run, he lost the child. So when he lost the child, he now lost faith in serving God. So he now lost faith in serving God, that he destined that he tell God, please, I don't think you exist. Because if you are existing, I don't think, as I'm serving you, then I do all the service you want me to do. How come you could not save my child? So therefore, I will not serve you again. So he denied God, he rejected God. He was about to even burn the Bible before someone dragged the Bible from her hand. So he was confused, he don't know what to do. So at night, he was dreaming that those people who are in the black uniform, they came to her. They now gave her a knife. They gave her a knife to kill herself. Okay. So he was dreaming that those people in black uniform was surrender her in the bed where she was lying down. So they took a knife. They said to her that this knife is for her. So the knife is for her. So the lady said, what am I going to do with a knife? He said, yes. Since you have denied your savior who created you, so you now belong to us. Everything about your life now belongs to them. So whatever they say to you, that is what you will do. The lady said, okay, what do you want me to do? They said, okay, this knife, you will collect it and stab yourself to death. The lady said, no, it cannot be possible. They say it must be possible. It must be possible because as it stands now, the God that you cherish so much, that you love so much, is no longer with you. He has rejected you. So your soul now belongs to them. So this is what the soul said to the lady. The lady say, okay, you people should give me time to think about it. If he will die or she will not die. So in that case, after they left, he opened the eye. He now see that it's a dream. Before when she dreamed this kind of dream, she will lead her and pray to God. But she don't remember to pray again because she has denied God. All what he'll do, he wake up in the morning and eat, he don't even fast again, he go to a place of work. So she worked like this from 1 year. Everything she ever labored for, everything started going down gradually. All these evil people started stealing for her. They started stealing things that make her happy. They started, as they stole the child, they stole her money. 419 became calling her, telling her that I am your brother, I am your this. And that memory could not even recognize that she's falling into the trap of enemy. Because why? She have removed the key of her life in the hands of God. All those stories I'm telling you is real story. It's not a fake story. She removed the key of her life in the hands of God. Because they say there is power in our tongue. Not that she go directly to remove the key of her life from the hands of God, no. But he removed the key of her life through her speech. Through her speech, because in this our tongue lies the power. In everything we said, it will be granted because it's your heart desire, it's your heart request. Whatever you request, that him will allow him to fall in your life. If you say that I am going to be a millionaire, no matter all the consequences I'm passing through, you are going to be a millionaire. If you say that I am going to be a failure in your life, it has been stealed from heaven. That is how it's going to be. If you say that you are going to die or terminate death, it's left for you. It's what you decide that God will assist you to do. Because first, he has died for us, for we to have victory, for we to be saved, for we to have self-defense, for we to be anointed, for we to be free in every areas of our life. Then it now came out that we that they died for, we are now looking at it as if it's not meaningful. They died, that Jesus died for us, is not worthful for we to praise him, for we to tell him thank you. Okay? This is the story of the woman. The woman lost everything that is hers. So one day, a friend now called her, directed her to native doctor. And she kindly accept, he admired the offer. They went to native doctor. The native doctor said that he is going to make love to her to regain everything that is lost. And at the point of making love to her, she got pregnant from the native doctor. You see how the devil now really he have so fruits. It's not only evil, it's not losing every, it's not that he lost all her property and lost her first child now. He now pregnant for the native daughter because they say when the devil collects the head, he will give somebody cap. And a cap without head, how is it going to look like? A cap without a head, you know. So this woman now find out that he has got pregnant, and the wife, the husband they have been looking for another child again. He did not have from the husband, but he now have from the native daughter. So he now went back to the native daughter. Say, you did not say that this thing that we do will lead to pregnancy. The man say, that is the fruit we are talking about. So we are talking about fruit. All fruit is not just all about wealth. Including pregnancy is the most fruit. You have to be glad. So go and tell your husband that you are pregnant. Because this is what you people are looking for. The woman say, it cannot be possible. The husband know that after the death of the child, both of them have not been compatible as before, because the memory of that child remain in their heart every day. So there's no how the man will agree. So the native daughter convinced the woman that the woman said, okay, you have no choice. You have to go and meet the husband that she is pregnant. So the husband said, this is what we are be praying for. So when the pregnancy was the stage of 7 months, the lady started having some nightmare that they will scream so loud that the whole neighbor will have to even get up and say, what is happening? In the 3 nights now, we have not been able to sleep very well because the child in her womb has started tormenting everything about their life. A child in the womb will get up from the womb, will be playing with some kind rat, some kind pussycat. The woman will be so shocked that what is happening? So you have to tell the husband, look at the nightmare I'm having in a result of this pregnancy. So they have to go to a hospital. So they check the pregnancy to see how they do DNA test. First, they find out that it's not the man's child, but it's a child. But the daughter, the situation of the child is confusing daughters. Why I am saying this story? Because it's a lady that have used his mouth to come and confess what had been happening between her and her creator. When you make enmity with your God, who is your creator, that means you are giving the long key to enemy, to the devil, to flog you. The flog that he will even flog you, not the physical flog that when you they flog you, you will feel a little pain, you will go away from the pain. No, this one is a lifetime flog. Because I see so many people today, when they are angry, they will say, God, you are not existing, you are doing. You might not know. You might be seeing that you are enjoying now. But this enjoyment is no longer coming from God. It's coming from the devil, because the devil wants to deceive you to enter their trap. When you not enter their trap, they will plant you a fruit that you will not even save. So this pregnancy is now climbed to 9 months. This woman refused to say where he brought this pregnancy from. He did not deliver after 9 months. This pregnancy, he claimed 1 year. This lady did not deliver. So a good Samaritan, that came to this woman that said, "Madam, you are gradually going down. What is wrong with you? Since you lost your child, we know that we lost you in the church. You, any member that stop you on the road to preach for you, you will spit on their face. But they still love you. Come back to Christ. Because this situation you are now, you need God." Wealth, he don't have it again. Job, he lost everything. Even the husband rejected her. Okay. Along the line, the woman forced her to back to church where he laid those confessions. And when they pray for this woman from 7 days, 7 nights, you behold what this woman is having in her stomach is not a child. It's a big serpent. It's a big serpent that he have eaten up this woman. And it's short. The main thing that made woman a woman, this serpent have finished eating them. This is what a love from native doctor do to this woman generation. Because the woman was saying that Jesus is her enemy. He made Jesus an enemy, and he came to jam the greatest enemy, which is only the love of God alone that can forgive us our ignorance. Because sometimes the ignorance of men even caused them to enter early grave. Just for example, the ignorance of this woman almost brought her to her early grave. After 7 days and 7 night prayer, before the snake left this woman tummy, nobody know how he left. But after that, the last day of the prayer, the woman went to horrible toilets. That the woman was feeling symptoms as he want to give birth to a child. That he started bringing rubbish, you know. At the end, the stomach go down. The woman have to fell down, started crying. Crying that God, is she sorry? She's sorry that she will never go away from God again. She did not know that she was thinking that she's doing the right thing. This is what happened to this very beautiful lady. This is the story of this lady. This is why I came here to tell you that we're about to enter New Year again. You might say that in the last years, you have prayed, you have been praying, you did not get anything from God. Now you have decided to go and check other side where people are checking. Those side that, you know what I'm talking about. There are some side that people used to check. Please, this area of check for me. Maybe you might not around, you might not be around, but you can give somebody money to check for you. You give somebody money, you are the person who is checking it. Okay? This check it something can gradually destroy your life. It can gradually destroy what you labor for. Because those enemies, they have one special spiritual mirror. They used to look at anything you are doing. Or if you are eating, they know you. If you are bathing, they know what you are doing. But you know why they cannot get access to your life? Because God has not given them go ahead. Because why? You still cherish God. You cherish your creator. So because of that, they will not get access. But they can watch you like television. They can watch you like movie. Okay? They can be watching you like movie. Anything you are doing, they know. But they cannot strike you. They cannot strike. This is why I come out here today to say that in this new year we are about to enter, if there is anywhere enemy are planning against you, they have taken your picture, they have taken any of your property, or someone bring your name to them to take to Chiraim to go and destroy you, as they are planning it, the day that they will assemble to carry out this plan, make them jam their early grave in the powerful name of Jesus. And as you are watching this video, you tap amen. You might look at me as, no, Jesus does not select who he sent message. Even in a madman can stop you on the road, tell you your life history. Even all those lady who you people saw as a fornicator, They can even tell you your life history. Blind woman can tell you what is going on in your family. But you as a person, you will ignore it. Say, oh, I go and sit down, you drunk. A drunkard can tell you. No, don't molest the world that any man stop you on the road to tell you. Don't molest them. Your all is to say thank you. When you reach home, try and search yourself. Search yourself, search your heart, because every one of us, we have history, we have past tense, we have story to tell. And our horrible story can bring any prophet to tell you your story is in the past. Because now we are about to enter new year. They are waiting, they are planning, they are setting trap everywhere around your neighborhood, where you are staying. They are using all efforts to make sure you don't see this new year. But I promise you, brother, sister, you are going to celebrate this new year like never before in the powerful name of Jesus. My name is Blessing Richard. I was born when my mother gave birth to me, it was three months later before I lost my mother. I don't know my mother. And the breast I suck is the breast of my grandmother. And I was thinking that my grandmother is my mother. Okay? I lost my mother at the age of 3 months. You people know, a child of 1 year is little. Man, where a 3 months child. So I am a child which God want him to live. A God have plan for me. And the situation by when you don't have mother, you have stepmother, you know how it is. You are born into a polygamous home. After the death of my mother, my father married another woman. My father loved me so much, although he's not alive again now. He also cherished me so much because he showed me love, because I don't have mother, I don't know my mother. But some people don't want my father to give me that love that I deserve. They call me all sort of name. I was the person who killed my mother. If my mother came to you that said that my child is my child that killed me, my mother don't die as the result of giving birth to me. He died after giving birth to me. How do I kill my mother? It's when I want to start sucking my mother's breast that I will not kill my mother. No. I still love my mother even if I don't know her. Because for her to bring me to this world, it's a powerful woman. It's a powerful woman. I give her thumbs up. Wherever her spirit may be, may her soul rest in perfect peace. I cherish my mother and my father, even in grave. If God bless me tomorrow, I'm going to celebrate their burial. So some of you who will have mother, who will have father, you will talk to your mother anyhow, you will use your mother to be playing ball. Let me tell you, it's not the will of God. Even in Bible make us to understand that a disobedient child, you know the consequences. I will not mention it. No matter what your mother do to you, if you know your mother have one leg, he have only one leg, he's a blind woman, he's a mad woman. Respect her, because for her to take you in her womb for 9 months, when you were a little blood, it did not destroy you. When he now born you to this world, people will now start it, because those people know the bond that you are having with your mother. They will try to disconnect that love. They will tell you, Demudia, see all your mates are buying car now since last year. Now they are still planning to buy another one. You are not just progressing. It's like your head, they smell. Your head, they smell. You have to go and ask your mother. Because if you refuse to progress, the fault might come from your mother or from your father. Your mother should tell you very well, because your mother might have one thing that you say, my children will not progress. Or maybe it will be using your progress to be making herself to shine. Then you as a son, as a daughter, mommy, I want to ask you something. Is that not a stupidity? You came your whole life. Your mother also have your life to live. So as you have, your mother have born you to this world, what you have to do, you have to stand for yourself, because there's nobody that don't have fault. The day they born you, you cry. What make a child to cry when he see the the condition of this world, that is why a child will open mouth when he just come out of his mother womb. That cry is the cry of which kind of wicked world is this? That is why a child is crying. Anytime you see that you born a child, he's crying. That is why you see when they born a child, the child don't cry immediately. The doctor have to make sure they use a better correct hand to beat her for nyash, so that he will cry, because that cry is very important. If he don't cry, they will not even celebrate that he have put to bed. If that cry, they want him to cry so that he will feel the what his mother and his father feel. From that day, the child started to experience what will happen to her or him, how he's going to progress in this world, how he's going to suffer before he now meets his match. This is why every child must cry when they're born there to this world. So it determines how what you came with in this world, because every child have his or her blessing, he have his or her glory. It depends on God, how you are going to make it here on earth. He started reading the day your mother put to bed. He started reading, your meter started reading from there. So it's not for you to go and be blaming your mother. Why did I not progress? Why did I not make it? Why did I not make it? No. All you have to do, you have to be loyal. Because a prayer of a mother it can go a long way from a life of a child. Please obey your mother. Obey your mother, because it's not we that said it, is God. That obedience, it will go a long way for your life. Please, mother, I also want to use this opportunity to beg you. You mother that cursed child, you are going to be useless. I just said no, the first day I give birth to you, you are useless. Oh, it's not good. It's very bad. How can you say the first day you give birth, because your child just offends you, say the first day I just give birth to you, I know that you are going to be useless. If it's useless, you are going to suffer it. Because all your mates that they give birth to the same time you give birth to this, they will be buying a gift for their mother. You will not have wrapper on your waist. Because why? You cause them so much. This is our tongue, there is power. Just listen to the story I told you just some minutes ago. He caused by what he said with his mouth. Not that he went to God physical to collect key, but he said it with his mouth that he don't have any key to do with her savior. Then you, a mother, instead of you to pray for your children to progress so that you can leave suffering, suffering can leave you, so that the stress you went through, they will not went through it. You will say you are useless like your father. You are useless like your father people. You are very stupid. You are a arm robber. Later, when the whole gone, you will now say, you said it before. Madam, it's not good. Let's be sincere. We are the backbone of our children. Okay? We are the backbone of our children. For example, I want to tell you the part of my story. Why I say we are the backbone of our children. When I was age of 15 years, I have my first pregnancy. The girl just graduated last week, Thursday now. So the father of this very girl, he rejected me because I was very little, and he himself is very little. I was suffering. My father brothers, they was beating rubbish away from my body. They make me to have hypertension. Hypertension that my mother did not bond me with, because when you are living with a people who don't love you so much, who hate everything about you, they want to beat the sickness into your life if you don't have that sickness. But they will make sure that, because when you are staying with person, that person is not showing you love. When you are seeing that person coming from work, immediately your heart will fly that, oh, I know that my time of suffering has, this is hour of my suffering again. But because when you are showing a child love, when that child is seeing you from afar, it will run. Oh, brother, welcome, sister, welcome. But when you are hating a child, you are beating her every slicey opportunity. Bo, 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 bo. When that child see you, her heart will develop fear. And when that afraid continue like that, it can cause hypertension. This is why my enemy is having hypertension today. Your enemy will have hypertension because of you in the mighty name of Jesus. This hypertension, my mother did not bomb me with heart attack. I received it because of my first child. Say, why did you have to get pregnancy? A child who has been suffering, where have no mother, the stepmother have been kicking her like a ball, like a football. You will kick her to this one will kick her to this. They will pursue her out. You will be going and begging for food. They drive you to go and meet your enemy. The enemy will say, thank you that you gave me this opportunity. They will do anyhow. And when they do anyhow, the result you will get, this is this. But I was, all my life, I was hoping that my God will answer me one day. They was telling me, go to abort this child. I said, no, I don't know. Even when they forced me to doctor. When doctor test my blood pressure, you see that all my blood was melted. If anything should force against my wish in my little death. So this is the anger they are having, that I don't allow them to do what they want. So before you know, slap started landing for my head like when mosquito bites you, you want to kill that mosquito. This is how the slap was flashing on my head. I almost run mad. But today, now go and look this girl. She graduated here. Last week, Thursday, my first daughter. My second daughter is graduating January. Now I'm age of 40. Because why? I never denied God. In all this pain, I never denied God. I suffer. It's not this one that I'm just saying now. I pray that one day I will come life to say my story. It will shock you that you are watching me. It will shock you. But I never give up. I never give up because I don't know how to give up. I don't know how to give up. Because if you look at it, a child who don't have a mother, you are believing in all this suffering. But if someone is up there watching over your going and coming, it be the mother that you don't have. It be the father that you don't have. Who are you to deny, to give up? No, I never give up. So when those my children started growing, I started having difficulties. I started having difficulties of how to train them. Even the Benima I married, last, he also ran away from responsibility. He left those children for me. I became mother of 5 children, taking care of them alone, no father, no mother, no relative to help me. I will go from farm to farm to work for my fellow women. Men, they will pay me money. Sometimes I will cook to go to sites to cook for people who are muddy block, who are building house in the sites. Sometimes a person will buy a site. I will tell the man, please give me the contract of this site. I can clear it. I can burn it. The man will look at me like this. Are you okay? Are you not a married woman? I say, yes, I'm married, but my husband is not with me. I am alone taking care of 5 children. So please, if you give me this contract, I will be very happy. The man will look, 20 acres of bush. A young lady will come out with a wheelbarrow pusher of rice, say that he can clear it. I say, just give me a try. I will be very happy. Can you imagine? I am begging to suffer. I have to beg somebody that I want to suffer for him. He will give me the contract. Before 3 weeks, everywhere will be cleared. I will draw the bush, I will draw the dirty, and I will burn it to ashes with my children. We were suffering together. But all this while, they will be asking, mommy, where daddy? I say, okay, your daddy, he went to work, he will still come back. But now they have grown. They now know that their father is short. It's a man that he don't supposed to live. He don't supposed to live, because when you brought children to this life, you now abandon them for one person. You are not deserved to live, because what are you doing? It's in the Bible. You don't supposed to bring children to come and suffer in this world. So I was suffering alone. At the time, I could not be able to pay my children's school fees. I have to negotiate if I can pass through land to desert. I negotiate, number one. I pass through desert. When I reach Libya, they will deport me back to Nigeria upon all the suffer. I also went second time. When I reach Libya, they will first of all prison me. I will stay for prison like 2 months. Why are they prisoning me? Because I went to Libya, there are a place that they will put women, a place that will put men. They don't join men and women together. My first deportation was Yaradua. If it is time for this Buhari now, I don't think they will deport everybody. The other people will just condemn all the whole people. May that soul of that man rest in perfect peace. I pray for God to make Nigeria to be a better place again. Because if Nigeria is a better place, I don't think so many of us will pass land to desert. So I don't blame those who is passing land to make their people to be happy. I don't blame them. But it takes the grace of God. Because it's not everybody that leave Nigeria to Europe has succeeded today. Some of them die in the river, in the process. Me, I know some of my friends that we crossed together. There were no more. So this is my third time in Italy here. This is my third time. I have suffered. So now that I'm being able to come out in internet to talk to my good people of God, to people who have the mind to serve God, and who are waiting for a person to tell them the good thing that God has done in their life. Maybe they can from there start to serve their God. Then enemy will say that he is taking my picture, that I will not have the strength. Where are you taking my picture to? If my picture is the one that will put food on your table, who am I to stop you? You never see when you bring picture of somebody, you now see that when you submit that picture, you yourself will now appear in that picture. That very picture will disappear. You will now become the person who is in that picture. Hey, you will tell the man, this is myself now. Hey, the man will say, yes, now you are not going back. This is the picture you brought for me. I am a counterfeit to my enemy. If you I say that you are a counterfeit to your enemy, no man will destroy you because you have passed through hell. You are about to enjoy the labor of your sweat. So any man that has jubilated, that he has succeeded in taking your picture, brother, let them take it. You will be alive to see what will befall them. In this your picture, we will bring destruction to all the generation of this very particular person. Don't worry yourself. All you have to do is just believe in God. Had the heart of forgiving. Forgive, because when you forgive, that very day, heaven will also forgive you. But when you are very difficult, you don't forgive. You don't expect God to forgive you. Okay? We have to let go, because in this world, people are burning of destroying you to see if you will fall in their trap. And having enmities, having grudges, making you, giving them the access to your life. Okay, please let go. Don't say that, hey, never in history will I forgive. Who are you? Are you the God? If God Almighty refuses to forgive you, will you be alive? No. Don't say that you will never let go. You must let go, okay? The day you let go, things will let go of you. Okay? Things will let go of you. Because you cannot expect to say you will not forgive you. Say God should come and forgive you. It's not possible. It's not done. So let go of things so that things will let go of you. Good afternoon, bros. So this is what I wanted to tell you all. And for you young lady who are about to marry, young boys who are planning to get marriage, please let God take control of your marriage. You boy, you girls, please do not say that I did not say this. If you look at where your mother is coming from, battling with this marriage, back then you have to sit down and look and search. Okay? Don't just look beauty. Don't look beauty, because in this very marriage that is happening today, is this confusion of beauty, is this, this is what I would say is the most important thing that destroy marriage. You look beauty, you admire beauty so much that you don't even intend to look inner man of that woman, inner man of that boy. You are so, I don't want to use that word blind. You are so confused that you look beauty. Mm-mm. My brother, don't look beauty. My sister, don't look beauty. Because beauty is not in any way to help you, to assist you. Beauty will just comply your confusion more and more. Because when you marry a woman that too beauty, it's every man's wife. It's every man's wife. A woman that is over beautiful. Oh, this woman know how to, he's very beautiful. You know how to dress. You know how to paint wet lips. When you are not around, remember that another man will help you to clarify that thing you are eating. You people will be eating it together. Don't just go for beauty, okay? Go for qualities. Quality about character. I'm talking to both boys and girls. I'm not talking to only the ladies alone. If you look at our four grandmothers and fathers, when you grow to know your mother, the mother who born as in your grandfather, you will see that the way they are living in their marriage, you will see that it's not all about beauty. It's all about love. Love. The love that binds this our great-grandmother together, we don't even open. They are so free. They love themselves. They don't want to go from marriage to marriage. They want to stay. In that time, they don't even do wedding. They don't do marriage. They don't even put ring. But their marriage is well solid. If you can doubt it with me, you can doubt it. But if you are really a person that who are used to tradition, who have grandmother, great-grandmother, you will see that the marriage, the experience then is more peaceful. Because if they are not peaceful, I don't think this extended family, it will be there. Because today now, look at some marriages. There's nothing like extended family again. A woman will lay one egg. He will go lay for another man. A man also, he will lay from here. Before you know, your children will start marrying themselves. Brother and sister will start marrying themselves. This is what is happening today now. You will not know your brother. You will not know your sister. All because of I will not say foolishness, because if I say foolishness, I'm a child of God. I don't want to. But ignorance. Ignorance is why those things are happening today. We are marrying ourselves, brothers and sisters. We don't know ourselves because of the ignorance of the man, because of the ignorance of the woman. If you are not ready for marriage, please just hold on. Let God direct you. Because a marriage is supposed to be better and for worse. You have to stay with that man. You don't marry because you have money as a woman. You will start disobeying your husband. It's not done anywhere. Because why I say my own marriage is an ancient marriage. I refuse to leave my husband. Then, it's an ancient marriage because I'm a woman who don't enjoy life. Where they say the girl, he enjoy life. He enjoy life as girl, they do girl. I don't do girl. Now one man, we marry me now. Now I bought those children. And this, my husband have two mama. They was beating me like their child. From fire to fire. They was beating me every day. And still, yes, I was there. I have five children in that family. I was living in family house. It's an ancient marriage because apart from my husband, I don't know any other man. I'm saying the truth. I don't know any other man. So if you are a girl, a lady, is you know the man that disveges you, you will cherish that man so much because why? You don't know any other man. But if you are a girl, you have tested so many men, you will never be comfortable with one. That is why if you are a girl, please limit the way you associate with so many men, because it will bring a disaster. Not only your life, even your generation or born. But this is the truth of God I'm trying to share for you. But some people of God will not tell you this truth, because they will only tell you, God will bless you. You will be great. You will have money. We are just all about money. Whatever you have money, you don't eat it. There are so many people who have money today, they don't enjoy the money. Because why? The truth, who's supposed to come first? There are some truth that's supposed to come before money. So that when this money comes, combined with this truth, you will now know how to enjoy life. But when a money comes without truth, you will be confused. That is why you see some people will go and hang themselves. I have money, I don't have peace of mind. They will go and hang themselves. Not that they are suffering again now, but a mistake that they're supposed to be corrected. Nobody tell them the truth to correct it. If you are a woman, let me tell you, if you see man that he cherish you so much, no matter how that man, if that man does not even have money, try to pray for him. Because we have the power to pray for men. They're our elders. Because in their realms, that God removed both that they used to create us. We are their junior. We are their helpmates. But some women don't want to respect their husband. It's very bad. That disobedience is not pleasing God. Anytime you disobey your husband, God is annoyed. He's really annoyed. It's part of sin. It's not only fornication. Even if you tell somebody you are crazy, it's sin. All sin are equal in the sight of God. Fornication is evil a little one. When someone fornicates, you say, God, I am sorry. But when you are beginning to do it, you say you are sorry. Everything you are doing, too much of everything is bad. Please respect men. They deserve our respect. Because I don't think without them, we will be created as a woman. God created us for we to be their helpmates. Please, you are in Europe, you are in Nigeria. I know that by the grace of God, this video must get to you. Try and settle down and watch it. You will pick some sense in what I'm saying. Don't look at me as I don't have an aeroplane. I don't have a helicopter. I don't have car. I don't have Versace. Okay? But at least as far as I'm not walking with leg, sometimes I see enter train. I enter bus. I don't even think that someone that have aeroplane is richer than me. Because on my own side there, myself, I am a big woman. Because if you can also wake up in the morning, like other people, you bath, you dress, you eat. What's different? Those rich people, are they not? They will see eat and bath, wear shirts. The difference is that they enter aeroplane. The aeroplane, have you not? There are some people who enter aeroplane to this Italy. But at the time of my deportation, at the time of Yaradua, I was deported with aeroplane. I was not deported with Lapadusa. So if myself, I have entered aeroplane, even if it's only once I have entered aeroplane. Aeroplane is not different. Aeroplane is aeroplane. The way all of them are flying for up, the way this one is still flying on the air. So please, when you learn how to let go, forgive your husband, you will see that the marriage you are into will be a better place for you. Not that I will not respect you. You don't have work. You are just a useless man. If I even leave you, I will see a better man than you. It is how you they lie. You want just to give yourself zero name, zero. Very soon your name will become zero. Because if man can change. It can change woman. Man can marry. But it will not appear from his life as if maybe. But when a woman started to jump from man to man, that respect that a God has made you to be a woman, that authority will be gradually, it will be decreasing. It will not increase again. Instead of the power that God gives you as a woman to be increasing, so that when you measure a word, it will come to pass. No, that power will not be there. Because what made that power to be there? You are distributing it and you are becoming gradually a zero. And when you become a zero finally, you don't come off for market. That time, yes, how market? That time market not there again. So please, we have to maintain who we are. We have to maintain who we are. If what I'm saying here right now is making you to be annoyed, please, instead of you to be annoyed, you better choose some words inside here, and it will really help you. Amen. Don't beat your wife. Don't beat your wife. Because you are giving them the hand not to pray a good prayer for you. When you are beating your wife, you are beat. I see some cases in Facebook where they write RYP, the husband I kill her, the wife I kill her. They won't now they tell the kill human being these days. Una they kill her like they kill goats. If you human being, you will just kill her. For what? See, whosoever that kill in life will not remain the same again. Because that heart, that soul that you destroy, it will be crying. And when you are sleeping, you see, you will not have comfortable. You will be asking yourself, I don't even think that I can kill. So I just kid. It will live with you all the days of your life. If time not taken, you yourself, you are going to be killed. Because it's God that said it, that those that kill by sword, they will also die by sword. Why must you kill? If this thing that you is about to make you to kill, if it not let you do again, you better let go. You move on. You move on. Because if two people are harsh at the same time, there's no how you people can live this marriage together. It's good that when man is harsh, a woman will calm down. Or when a woman is harsh, a man will calm down. In this very, very act, both of them can enable to move this marriage forward. But when the two partners will not listen to anyone, you better find your way before you will resort to killing things. You better find your way, leave that marriage. Okay? If marriage don't let you marry, you the one way be say God give you, do one. Don't force yourself. If he says of you to kill, you better don't kill. Man, don't kill your wife. Wife, don't kill your husband. Mother, don't kill your child. Child, don't kill your mother. I don't want to go into that aspect of the other money things. The next time I will go, I just want to focus on about life. How God wants us to live. So that we can have all the benefit that he needed for us. Any day we are sad, God is not happy. Any day that tears fall out in your eye, God is not happy. Because it's not the life that God wants for us. God wants the betterment of our life. So that we live life to the fullness. So that when you say, God, I thank you, it will give him, it will make him in heart to be glad to do another one for you. But when you are complaining, it make God to be sad. You don't have to complain. You don't have to complain. When I launch my music, I invite so many people. I think I print about 50 something handbill. No one remain. Everybody that I give, sister, I will come. What happened that day? And I also come out internet to beg them, please try and come. On that very faithful day. If I tell you that the person that came, I don't even think they are out of three. They are not out of three. But I say give glory to God. I also come out for internet to thank them. I thank them. I say, please, don't think that I'm annoyed for you because you did not come. No, I'm not annoyed because there are many celebrations ahead. You come, you not come. I really appreciate you as a person. I'm not annoyed, okay? If you want to call me to tell me the reason why you not call, or you want to send me a message, feel free. I'm not annoyed. Maybe you think I am expecting your money, that's why I'm inviting you. No, I'm not expecting your money. But if you can be able to use your church, you might say, sister, I dash you this one out of my mind. I will gladly take it, but I will not ask you because you did not send me a message. Maybe they were thinking they were afraid that they did not come, I would be annoyed because I did. No! Let me tell you, I am a secret millionaire. You don't think that I'm inviting you for my this thing is why I am looking for money. No! I just want us to be assisting each other. Because if those people that I invite, if they came that day, the hall will be so full. You know? The hall will be so full. The whole thing will look so nice because I even prepare food. I cook food. I make pepper soup, goat pepper soup. I bought a full goat. Okay? So because I want us to jubilate together. The money is just a money is not a something that you can just proud of. Like you have to proud of your person, proud of a human being first. Then money can come later. Okay? So please, this is why I forgive those people because they did not offend me. The only crime they commit that they did not come to my celebration. And the celebration will not lack for our life in Jesus' name. I'm still going to celebrate, so I'm still expecting them. So if they did not come for the first time, they can come in the second time. What just matters is for us to let our heart to be free. Because me, I have seen things that tear my heart in the past life that I live. I don't want anything to happen to my heart again. Because this is the time I'm supposed to be happy. Because my children, they are growing. Very soon, I will soon be receiving gift for my children. At least my last birthday, my children from Nigeria, he did a big frame. Say, mommy, this is your birthday gift. And he delivered it from Nigeria to Europe. You see my video. As the second one see that the senior one do frame, that one say, mommy, hey, I will see do. That one do a big pillow. Design it with so many love, showering me love. You see, posted it to me. You see? So this is because why I always pray for them. I always tell them that no matter how you think that your father, you have not seen your father, he's calling you on the phone. Please, don't be offended. I know that I have not been there for you all. Now that you are grown, he's even asking you, say, please, can you send me the charge card of 100 naira? A father that left a child when the senior one was even 15 years. You, when you needed your children, you abandoned them. Now you are not calling them now. Because you see that the woman your supposed wife is now in abroad. I waited for my husband for good 2 years in the family house. Because why? I don't know any man. So even in that 2 years I was waiting for them, the mother and the sister, they were beating me heavily. That I was the person who brought poverty to their son. That's why their son run away from me. If I tie my husband mother wrapper like this, as a husband mother, let me tie the wrapper. When he's coming from the market, he saw that wrapper on my waist. He slapped. I was even thinking that I am suffering in the hands of my brothers. But I now know that when I leave that oneself is heaven. I leave heaven to hellfire. I wait for my husband 5 years without no man. My mother brothers in Benin, all of them, they now break fight. There was a time they had that they beat me. I was admitted in the hospital. So they came from all the way from Benin to bring fight to my husband's house. So when I heard in the hospital that my mother people came from Benin to fight my husband people, I used phone. That time there was Nokia, 3310 when they ring. Ta-na-na-na, that you people know 3310 now. I called them, said, brother, please, don't fight my husband people. I defend them. I even warn them, please, don't fight for me. From there, they say, okay, so all what they are doing to me, I say, yes, I'm enjoying it. If I don't enjoy it, are you the one that will marry me? So please, who am I going to leave my children with? I have to stay with my children. I have to defend them. So they left. They did not come and fight for me again. They say, when you die, we will come and we will buy better coffee to bury you. That is what they promised me. But when they said that word to me, I was tears because I wish my mother was alive. My mother would have known what I'm passing through. He would know that it's not easy for a woman to leave her children. Because my mother gave birth to 3 of us. I was the only girl, I'm the last born. This my senior daughter, my senior brother, the year he graduated, Augustine, he died. So we remained 2. My senior brother, that one is living in Benue State. My mother never leave my father, so I did not learn that. So they decide to leave me so that I can suffer and die. But all glory to God. This is why the reason say I will serve my God to the fullness. Or see where God say yes in my life. No man. No woman. I will not die before my time. I cannot die. Also my children, they will not die. I leave my children now. This is 5 years. The senior one was the one taking care of the rest. Because I have no father, I have no mother. The senior daughter was the one taking care of the rest. So they were living in the rent. They were living in the rent. Now they are not living in the rent. They are living in my house. Because this girl, those children was running from church to church. When I was in the prison in Libya, they were running from church to church to pray for me. Sometimes they will even use the opportunity to tell pastor, please, can you borrow us 2,000? We have garri, we don't have soup. This is why I cherish those churches that I was attending in Nigeria. They never left my children in hungry. They will give them the 2,000. They will also give them some pepper. They will mix it together. Those children have suffered for me. Who am I going to spend the money for if not for them? Lady, if you are in Europe here, I beg you in the name of God, you have children in Nigeria. Please, before any other person you are sending money for, make your children to be comfortable. Because a prayer of a children also go a long way in the life of a mother. Okay? I can also say the benefit I am enjoying here today, my children, they are the reason of it. They are the reason of it. Okay? Don't abandon your children. No matter anyone you will born here, he cannot grow. He cannot grow than the one you have in Nigeria because they are the first. Okay? Please, pray for your children. Remember them. Remember them in anything you are doing. Any money you are sending, you want to build house, you want to buy a car, is good. But make them to be okay first before you can think of any other thing. In that very case, you are in that way, you are making God to be happy with you. Okay? So, this is what I am trying to say. Okay? Please, try to be at peace with your partner. Try to believe that there is God. Try to take important things of God. Try to take it serious. And above all, don't condemn men of God. Don't condemn them. Don't judge them. Because you are not the person who called them. Let the person that called them judge them. Okay? And if you also have any way you can assist people, orphanage home, please. Pay your homage to orphanage home. They are very important. The prayer those children would pray for you will go a long way. Okay? It will go a long way. Orphanage home, if it is half bag of rice and 10 carton of Indomie, just send it for them. Send it for through the reliable source. Because today, so many people are using this orphanage home, the name of orphanage home, to collect money for people, which they don't even have any file they are taking care of. But they will say, hey, we are the branch of orphanage. We help of... No, it's a lie, oh. I have seen that kind of cases so many times. They will be the one to be tasking you. Hey, brother, when are you sending the money now? Is it how it's supposed to be? You volunteer to do something. They will now be the people who will be using their phone to distract you. Hey, brother, we are still waiting for you. We have sent the account. No. It's not supposed to be like that. It's not supposed to be like that. So this is where I am telling you, please, try and listen to this video and pray to God to help you in Jesus' name. Until I come your way next time, try to be good. Try to be good. Try to respect your mother. Try to respect your wife. Try to respect your husband. Try to pray for your children. Okay? Try to do good. I try to forgive. So, I have to pray with you before I go. Close your eye. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that this word that I say to your children today, may it dwell into their hearts. May they abide to it and follow the rule and regulation. Father, as they do this, may their life experience glory upon glory. May their life experience long life and prosperity. As we're about to step into this new year, Father, I steal their life with the blood of Jesus. That no weapon formed against them that prosper. That any man or woman who take their picture to Kovu, let them use their head to carry the debt they are planning for this individual. Father, I pray for anyone that's watching me. As you type amen, may your life be blessed all the days of your life. May you not jam bad people. May bad people never jam you. Everything that you are expecting in the hands of God, may God Almighty bless you richly in the mighty name of Jesus. As I use myself to make make an example. May the example that I am experiencing in my life today, may it also happen to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Because if I am experienced bad, I will not use myself to pray for you. As I am experienced good, may you experience this good in the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name,